Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Marion. Today I'm doing this glam makeup look using products that are new to me and that's been in my stash but not new to the market. But before I get started, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel. Make sure you hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. And without further ado, we're gonna hop right into this video. Today is just basically me doing a full face using products that I have never used before. They're new to me. They're not new to the market. But if you've seen any of my makeup collection videos, then you know I have a lot of products that I have not dipped into. And I'm just like, you know what? There's no need to hold on to the stuff and not know whether or not it works for you. To start off, I am using the Keys Soul Care Comforting Scented Lip Balm in Lucid. This is what it looks like because my lips are extra dry. I have not put any primer on. I am going to do my brows off camera, but I did want to show you what I am using. I just don't want this video to be extremely long. I am using Wanda Beauty Frame Your Face Micro Brow Pencil. This is in dark brown. In my opinion, it just looks like a normal brow pencil. Like, that is real thin. And hopefully it's my color. I think I got this in a BoxyCharm. So I'm gonna do my brows off camera and then come right back. Okay, so I'm back. Brows are done. The pencil, I really like it. It's nothing, you know, mind-blowing, but it did what it needed to do. I still prefer Benefit's Precisely My Brow, but that'll do for now. So moving on to eyes, I have different palettes here that I want to either try out today. Both of them are from Morphe. I have the P9 Petal Passion, and then I have the it's the 9P Petal Passion. And then I have the 9R Bronze Metal. And then, so this is what bronze metal looks like. Very cute, very simple. Something I probably used before. And then for Petal Passion, which I think I'll probably use these colors before too. But it's very light and bright. So I think I'm gonna go into Petal Passion. It's summery, it'll work. Prime my eyes. I'm using P. Louise Base Rumor 2. Haven't used this in a minute. Okay, so my crease do get a little oily, so I'm gonna have to set it real quick. Okay, so I'm back. I did part of my eyes. This palette has a lot of fallout and I need to definitely clean one of my eyes before I proceed, because I mean, there's a lot going on. And this is the main reason why I do eyes before face. For the simple fact of having to clean up if there's a lot of fallout. This eye here was kind of hard to do because I think when I set the base, it made it hard for the shadows to kind of stick, but it shouldn't do that because I don't have any other issues with other shadows whenever I set my crease because I have oily lids. But I'm gonna move on. I'm not gonna, going on a whole little rant. I do have a little sample size Laura Mercier Pure Canvas Primer. It's hydrating. It says it's silicone free. Do you have this primer? If I like it, I'll buy it because I don't have as many foundations as I have. I don't have a lot of primers, which isn't a bad thing because once I find a primer I like to stick to it. But the primers, the smell on this, it's a weird smell. Everything I get lately has been a weird smell. But wow, the smell is, it just caught me off guard. So my apologies. I'm trying to figure out, do I want to use the new Lancome or Makeup Forever HD? This is slightly darker. This is slightly light. I'm gonna use this. I have a new brush from Alicia Keys. It's the Natural Flush Complexion Brush. I don't think this is for foundation. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, no, it's not for foundation. If I can get it out of the thing. Okay. Maybe I don't want to pop out. So your girl literally struggled to get this damn brush up out of the packaging. I'm thinking I'll probably use this for blush or something. I don't know. So I'll just go in with a sponge. And I think this is, yeah, this is a Morphe Cherry Coke sponge. It was a part of the collection. Let me shake this up again. Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up. So since I am using the HD by Makeup Forever, I'm just gonna use this to set my face. Let me go ahead and take it out the packaging. I can't get over the smell of the primer. It's all over my hands. What the hell? Okay, so let me pump this on the back of my hand. So I think I've applied enough. Those three pumps did me well. So we're going to move on to concealer. Now with concealer, I have Dose of Colors Medium Tan. This is Meet Your Hue Full Coverage Concealer. This is what the packaging looks like. And then I have Jaclyn Cosmetics Medium Neutral Concealer. Now I heard with this concealer, you have to hurry up and blend it out. You can't just let it sit on your face because it dries fast. And then, so I'm trying to decide, you know, what do I want to do? What do I want to do? I think I'm gonna try this one. You know, me being a little daredevil. So let's do just a little. I'm gonna do one eye at a time. If you hear my daughter laughing in the background, she's watching something on YouTube. Okay, this is thick, so I can kind of see why it dries down fast, because it is, if I'm not mistaken, full coverage. So I'm gonna hurry up and blend this out. I'm gonna put a little on my nose. I'm not for sure if I wanna do my forehead, but I'm definitely gonna do my nose. Just a little on the forehead. I said a little and I end up putting, in my opinion, a lot. Let me do the forehead first. Yeah, you definitely have to move fast with this concealer. Definitely. But it's a good concealer, in my opinion. So I don't have a translucent powder, a new one, but I do have Jaclyn Cosmetics Brightening Banana powder. And I feel like I should have got the more not so they had like a different shade. It was similar to banana, but it was I feel like a little bit more neutral. But we're gonna see how this goes. I'm just gonna do a little because I don't want to go overboard with these products and be looking like a clown. When I tell you, it took me about 10 minutes to take the wrapping off of it. The price of having long nails. Pray for me. Let's use a clean sponge. This is an e.l.f. sponge. Dab out the excess powder. Okay, so it's finely milled. It's definitely brightening, but I'm gonna tone it down when I use the makeup forever powder. Yeah, because this is definitely brightening my face. I feel like a little too bright, if you get what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure I wasn't supposed to apply it on my forehead and it was only supposed to be for under eye, but oh well, you know, when you have a routine and you're so used to doing certain things, it's kind of hard to like remember, okay, no, that only goes under your eye. Girl, what's next? I'm just looking at my vanity like, you got all this stuff to try out and you don't know what's next. I guess I'll just set my entire face with the Makeup Forever Blurring Powder Foundation. And let's see if that's gonna help your girl, cause this is dark. This is dark. Let's use a little. First, let's put it up here. You see how it's kind of like helping that area? It definitely, I can see a difference right here. Okay, so my face is looking extra, extra powdery, but before I spray it, bronzer. I have Glamour Bronze by Morphe. This is in, what shade, Leader. This is definitely dark, girl. I have to go in with a light, light hand. It's very powdery, so. It's powdery and it's too red. It's too red. It's too red, but I'ma work with it, okay? I ain't got no choice, honestly. No choice. At this point, all I wanna do is spray my face, okay? Spray my face. I feel like this side is higher than this side, but it's all right. Ain't going well. I don't think. Okay, so moving on to blush. I have One Size Cheek Clapper 3D Blush Duo in Freaky Peach. Let's see what this is all about. And this is the blush. This is a cream. Ooh, I like this. Okay, Patrick. It applies so out of everything I've used in this video. The blush, oh, I'm gonna have to go back and get the other shades. Patrick. I've never really just been hyped up about a blush before the way that I am about this one. It's just the quality of, I mean, let me stop before I go overboard with it, because this is can be used kind of like as a highlight. So I mixed both of them together, but just look, like I'm looking in the mirror and it's just, it's beautiful. I don't know how it's coming off on camera, but in real life, right now, I like this. Go get this blush. Lashes, 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 lashes. So I could either use the lashes I got with my last unit from Unice Hair. These are some very whoosh lashes, like not to be played with. You see how these lashes look? Like, oh my God. I think they get a little bit too much for me today, but I definitely will rock them. And I also have Juvia's Place Nubian Lash Egyptian Lights. These are 16 millimeters, so they're like a natural volume. Or I can do the Juvia's Place Nubian Lash Nefertiti 16.5. I'm thinking this is more my style, especially for the eye look. Look what I just did. Look. I'm gonna put these lashes on and then I'll be right back. Okay, okay. Last but not least, before my battery die on my camera, is lips. So, something new today. I am using Juvia's Place Luxe Liner in Lush. This is what it looks like. Gonna hurry up. And then I'm gonna use a Mauve Moment. Simple and cute. So this is the final look, using products that are new to me, but not new to the market. They've been in my stash, or I recently purchased these items. What do you think? How do you feel about this look? The lashes, I definitely have to cut to trim to fit my eyes. One is coming up because my allergies started to kick in, but needless to say, I'm gonna fix it. Everything, I really don't have anything bad to say except the eyeshadow has major kickback. So if you don't like a lot of fallout and all of that, then that palette isn't for you. I really love, out of everything that I've used, the One Size Blush Trio. That is my favorite out of everything I've used. But if you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Make sure your notification bell is turned on so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. And as always, thank you for watching.